Dos vale, what the hell? This guy. The man. You just chill. Your motherfucking dad. You just chill. Yo, that's my note. What you gonna do? Well, that's crazy thing. What? What? Nah, what he gonna do?
This team that I really was supposed to use. My last video was an hour because I didn't know the team, but this time I'm gonna do it. This is a great Earth team. Probably should have brought probably should brought Diablo something. This should do right here. If I use Beatrix skills more often. Wait a second, how would I got some holes in it? That's stupid, why? That was I don't feel like there we go. There we go. You just my vision. That's messed up. They're dying out. That's messed up. That's stupid. I was like doing it all. What if you're a drug, dude? I probably should have brought Diablo or Odin, but. These some tanky boys.
Every potential reality of the show as it could be has some effect, big or small, on the show as it is. This is why Twin Peaks is a sort of meta approach to the spiritual and surreal elements, because the show is exploring potential realities and their value. Lynch is very preoccupied with the nature of reality and dreaming in all his works. In a famous quote that he used when describing the meaning of Inland Empire, pulled from the philosopher named Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, reads as follows. We are like the spider. We weave our life and then move along in it. We are like the dreamer who dreams and then lives in the dream. This is true for the entire universe. This quote is spiritual in nature, but can be read through the lens of several different philosophies, including existentialist and postmodern philosophy, both of which
Lynch forgot her buff just went out.
The quote is shortened in Lynch's own work as the phrase, we live inside a dream.
Can't be messing up like this.
Dreams, and it's also about fiction, but importantly, it's about reality. What Lynch is saying, what the philosopher is saying, ties into the basics of postmodern theory that I referenced in the introduction video for this series, limited perception. We are all taking part in a strange, abstract realm we call reality. This reality is being filtered permanently through a fixed consciousness, our individual perception. My perception is different from yours, and because of this, we're sharing this collective consciousness in different ways. We're both on the planet Earth together at the time you're watching this video, or experiencing it permanently from our own bodies, me from mine, you from yours. Postmodern theory puts forth that because we can never experience information in its fullest, most objective state, and always
it's gonna spam his scale too here.
Including its own faults and flaws and limits, we are only experiencing a small percentage of reality at any given time. This leaves us susceptible to error and further manipulation. Postmodern theory promotes skepticism of universal truths by acknowledging the faults in human perception that we are all capable of. Theories of performativity and other postmodern theories put forth that, rather than receiving certain things, we, in a way, constitute them. James Butler argues, for example, that our acting out of gender roles in society constitutes our gender, rather than the fact of our anatomy. And solipsism as a philosophy is all about acknowledging that, since we are only able to perceive from our own perspective, we effectively can't prove that anything exists except ourselves. In movies like The Matrix, postmodern theories are explored through science fiction. How do we know what we believe to be real is real? If perception is faulty, then we could all be plugged into a machine and not know it. Anything's possible. Postmodern theory doesn't suggest such absurd extremes, but instead suggests that, since any potential reality can be obfuscated by limited perception, we have to carefully consider all information we're presented with, as well as the lenses through which we view this information. So what does the quote that Lynch likes to pull from mean? It means that from birth we are placed in a form of consciousness that allows us eyes into the reality before us. As such, we basically create what we know to be reality through our perceiving it, as though we are dreaming real life. Perception is created by our brain, just like a dream is, and then we live in the reality that we perceive, just like a dreamer creates the dream to then live inside of it. Lynch seems fascinated with this idea and likens fiction itself to dreams, hence his surrealist vision for most of his original works. Not that his films portray one dream narrative and one actual real story. It's all fiction. None of it is real. Instead, all fiction is a dream, a collective dream that we participate. participating by viewing it, hence creating our perception of it, creating the dream, and then living inside it by becoming immersed in its world.
Yeah, trash wave. He hath guile, this is fodder.
It's our dream as we watch it, Lynch's dream as he makes it. It's the sort of universal solipsism that Lynch seems to be promoting his work by suggesting that it's not the presence or absence of reality that matters, but the nuggets of truth that you pull from any potential reality. Twin Peaks uses spiritual elements to play around with the potential realities that show in universe, just as the creators show play around with the potential realities that show outside of the universe of the show.
Yeah.
The reason why the show seems to have a trail of breadcrumbs, but really doesn't, is because the audience seems primarily concerned with logic, while Lynch is primarily concerned with meaning and aesthetic. And there's an important difference. A scene doesn't have to have a clear conclusion in order to mean something. The giant's presence can be meaningful, even if it doesn't lead to a clear resolution. People got used to viewing TV as, if A and B, therefore C. They expect that, since there is a profound sense of mystery, there must be a single answer. Lynch isn't looking for answers.
Forgot about it when their C65 is actually useful. I never use it.
The meta spiritual elements of Twin Peaks continue to inform the meaning of the show well past its original run in the Firewalking and the Return.
What?
The notion of potential realities becomes even more prevalent in those later editions of the series. Here in the original show, it's definitely present, but it's not fully given its proper context until the end of the Return, when it becomes clear just how much the spiritual aspects of the show are toying with the meta. Cooper is, throughout the show, one of the more aware characters of the potential realities that exist all around him, and is also the one seemingly most aware of the supernatural elements of the world he belongs to. Arguably, the Log Lady is slightly more aware of things than Cooper, but her role is far less involved.
He should die first.
Various potential realities become revealed to Cooper.
Yeah.
Made aware of the unreality of his own world as audience surrogate to give us the opportunity to reflect on both his world and his own. Is the Red Room? Well, to my understanding, it's like a sort of waiting room between two different states. The most obvious answer is a waiting room between this life and the afterlife, or between life and death. Cooper waiting in the Red Room for 25 years prior to the return is like being in a comatose state, as though one were between being alive and being dead. What do people do in the Red Room? They mostly just sit and wait for something to happen. But what causes things to happen? I already think of the show as being a bit spiritual. The spirituality of the show is contrived deliberately by the creators in order to create the story that we see. So why does Cooper finally leave the Red Room 25 years later? Because the story needs him to be back. He can now leave the waiting room. Now let's bring this fully into the meta. Let's
think of the Beatrix.
Prominently seeing why one would wait in a room adorned with red curtains. Red curtains are associated with the show business, most prominently film and theater. A theatrical performance uses red curtains to obscure the front stage from the audience and also to obscure the backstage from the audience. An audience member uses the fourth wall as a window into a theatrical production world, and the red curtains ascend to allow us to see it and descend to prevent us from seeing it so that they can make changes while we're not looking. While this is all happening in the front stage, and the backstage, also sometimes obscured by red curtains, actors wait for their part of the story to come up, and the people involved with the production often hurry to switch outfits for actors and whatnot. Basically, the red curtains obscure our...
Now I'm gonna just brave attack with her so Gal can have some brave. That's a 200 IQ move.
I like to think of the Red Room as being the backstage of the show of Twin Peaks. If you think about it this way, when Cooper leaves the Red Room in the Return, he returns to the world of the show. If the show were a play, then the world of Twin Peaks would be the front stage, and his return would be to the story. Just as a character in a play, he would be a triumphant return after being fought dead. They would return from the backstage and be invisible. The screen itself is the fourth wall of TV and film, and they don't require a curtain to obscure the front stage because they can manipulate what we're seeing at all times. But the Red Room, to me, reads as a backstage for the show, where people wait to be reintroduced into the narrative of the show. Or the world.
Love using Beatrix.
It doesn't really happen while characters are in the Red Room, and more just kind of stops. A lot of what happens in the Red Room is people waiting around while the story happens in their absence, just like waiting in the backstage for that time to be called back to the story. So when Twin Peaks is showing us the Red Room, they're showing us the backstage of the narrative. They're implying the unreality of the narrative.
Never skip an EX. I know she's going to get broken, but he should get broken too.
There's some unknown place that the characters can find themselves in. Cooper discovering the Red Room is basically Cooper discovering the fourth wall, or discovering what lies behind the world of Twin Peaks itself.
going much faster.
Cooper entering the Red Room and Beyond Life and Death is Cooper transcending the narrative of Twin Peaks and showing him and us the nearly unfathomable notion that he is not real, someone manufactured. He is fiction, and he and we are being made aware of this fact. Now, if you want to go further with the backstage metaphor, think about who ends up in the Red Room, why, and what that entails. Let's focus again on Dale Cooper. In the International Pilot, he defeats Bob, and the story ends right there. The story ends, of course, because the creators expected that to be the last of the show and wanted to give it a sense of finality just in case.
Double battery. This is great. You played yourself. This is the HP attack, I think.
Serves very little function for the narrative, and then the story starts over at the end with him in the Red Room again. And then a new story starts, and then it ends abruptly, and we see one final shot. What is it? Again, Dale Cooper in the Red Room. All major threads of each story end up in the Red Room, meaning every story ends with Dale and Laura as well, retreating to the suspended state where they can have no further story beyond the narrative.
I think this the H. I think this is the HP dump.
That's the only way he will be let out, because Twin Peaks is breaking the fourth wall with the Red Room, acknowledging these stories as fiction.
If I was confident enough. I think I can take it. Hold up.
Well, because with all fiction, the fourth wall is what separates two worlds.
Okay, I think I can take it. Oh, I still have, I have Holy Knight. I didn't see that. And he missed. I can't believe this.
She was told the real dice. I just walked into her damn house and saw how people get killed. And we walked. Just walked right into my house.
That is how the show is.
Just walk right in.
I know, I just walked. I just walked.
I don't know, sorry.
Where people are working live with trauma that will happen forever, even if they escape it. If we solve Laura's mystery, the TV show ends, and we have to go back to the real world, where so many girls like Laura are brutalized and killed at the hands of horrible men, while others neglect and ignore.
It's just one. I'll have 60 some turns left. It should be enough.
Ourselves from fiction using reality, and we can distance ourselves from reality using fiction. This is what TV and film have capitalized on heavily, and especially so during the 1980s.
I should have just spammed scale one. I should have.
I've covered this in an article on my Patreon where I applied to video game violence. Fiction often resolves moral conundrums for us so that we don't have to feel the need to do anything about the world around us having serious issues.
Yeah, got a lot of less buffs. I use less buffs. I use less skills. I'm very conservative with skills. So that's why I like Boss Rush so much. It forced me to act like a fool. We can act like some fools. Look at that heel.
The surreal elements of the show also reference contemporary media of the time by suggesting things about television as a medium and the kinds of things that air on TV. Just as the 50s aesthetics are referencing the sudden fondness
of the
surreal elements are suggesting the way in which television portrays our culture. But I'm sorry, but it's what?
Look how conservative of skills I am. She still has a. It's just ridiculous. I think I'll have the EX wedding. It's gonna hurt. Oh no.
Mine should be like PO.
This is why I say that the Red Room is a waiting room between life and afterlife. Because it reminds us.
Nah, I'll say that for next wave. I'm gonna melt through the next wave like butter.
That behind the front stage of our life, there is a backstage that we're not perceiving. Maybe it's not.
Yeah, all three EX is gonna be ready, I think. Yeah, it's GG.
The great unknown is poked at with Twin Peaks' surreal elements.
Watch this shit. Watch this.
It faces us with an infinite potential.
I'm playing here for 3 years.
There is so much more than the limited perception we get, and Twin Peaks exposes the characters and us to this aspect of our reality. The importance of potential realities in Lynch's work relates in part to this existentialist notion. That when faced with the great absurdity of existing, our limited mortal lives, we have to find a way to make meaning. The grandiose surrealism of Twin Peaks isn't meant to only provoke us to think about those elements, but the small town and the small world we live inside. It's meant to make the lives of the characters and the lifespan of the show itself that much more meaningful because of the potential for disruption or even non-existence. A lot of Cooper's silly yet iconic quotes relate to this too, as Cooper seems to live life by a philosophy of finding meaning and value in little things, even if they seem inconsequential. The quote about allowing yourself to get once a day, or about whittling because that's what you do in a tower, a yellow light, and then slow down instead of speed up. In fact, Cooper's whole characterization really captures the themes of learning the way
that's
in the face of
existence,
right? As he repeatedly lost himself, brings coffee, dogs, and pie, and generally seems to appreciate the moment.
That's a nigga in your
blood. Finally, to close out our discussion of the supernatural elements of the show, they also reflect on the most modern, concept of the series is about. See, as life continually became modernized after World War II, the entering of the postmodern era, all the shifts in the way life was lived on the basis of level, meant that we became increasingly susceptible to human manipulation. The postmodern era is one in which life is fully given itself to capitalism and other forms of unequal authority. The forces of capitalism are forces we don't always see guiding our lives, but they guide us nonetheless. Media impacts the way we view the world, but media is it's the easiest thing in the world. Constructed with specific purposes, and this affects us.
It's the easiest thing
in
the world. Do I like it? Nigga.
Oh, this is gonna be just gonna bop. Barely had to use anything. That shit look light to y'all.
Twin Peaks was a major moment for Lynch as an artist, as it's one he took his realism into the mainstream. Episode 29 in particular feels like a course correction for his career, as he had started to embrace realism.
Oh, wow. That's funny as hell. That was funny. I know that was funny. We'll say, like a little girl, she never seen those big ones before. Like, 100 years old. See, 100 years worth of nigga.
We're not only watching a story, we're watching the destruction of a story.
You got a 3-day IQ. Well, glad I used that. Seems like it would have been over. Well, it's gonna let him spawn the other three for more Brave, but oh well. Yeah, I'm not gonna go to the Reddit for the Lufenia on level 20. I'm confident enough to do it by myself. And it's night night.
A big old tease.
As is now legend among Twin Peaks fans as well as production hell history, the network began to lose faith in the show and forced the creators to reveal the identity of Laura's killer. Before we can talk about the reveal as it happens in the show, we have to talk about a few things pertaining to the decision to reveal the killer.
easy. So I'm about to show you the units that I have for you. All the units that I use, you can pause, look at it.
But in terms of realism and investment in the story, something eventually needs to happen. Imagine if the show ran for 8 seasons, entirely off of the lore of mystery.
And here are all the units that are free.
That would be 8 years for one singular investigation.
Yeah, I'm fairly confident for level 20.
It could have worked.
Gonna be Parom Lightning. And whoever else is needed. Yeah, Pearl, Lightning, maybe either Warrior of Light or Furion. Well, Pearl is one of my favorite support units, so who knows? See ya.